Jodie Comer, Tom Hardy, Michael Shannon, and Austin Butler star in this 2023 film about a biker club that becomes a crime syndicate. We'll talk about the BIKERIDERS coming up tonight on Mikeylito's Matinée. Your mileage may vary. You've been warned. Hello again, everyone. Mikeylito here with another Matinée review. I'm just your average moviegoer, and each week I try and give you my honest opinion about a major motion picture. Before we begin, please like and subscribe to the channel. Click that bell and select all so you won't miss any video or stream. And follow me on X at MikeylitoLIVE for any late-breaking information about the channel. And you can also check the community tab right here on YouTube. Usually, my reviews are non-spoiler reviews. Well, look in the upper left-hand corner. I don't feel I should review this movie without this banner. I can't discuss the film without it becoming obvious very quickly what my thoughts are about the film. Our movie this weekend is The BIKERIDERS, a fictional adaptation of a photo book by Danny Lyon about a real-life motorcycle club in Chicago. And I think I have a picture of the book. There it is. The BIKERIDERS by Danny Lyon. I just checked before the broadcast on Amazon.com. All of a sudden, this photo book is very expensive. Gee, what a surprise. You see that picture on the book cover. Now, take a look at this. Seems very familiar, doesn't it? Written and directed by Jeff Nichols, I must keep emphasizing that the story itself, while it parallels actual events and somewhat identifies real people, the film's storyline is not true. For reference after the review, check out the recommended reading link in the description of this video for more information. On its face, this movie has a great cast. Austin Butler, who plays the handsome yet troubled Benny, who we meet when the film opens, and yet another example of in medias res, which is Latin for we're starting in the middle of the story instead of the beginning, which is an overused device in a lot of Hollywood productions these days. We've seen the opening scene in the trailers. It's the one where two brothers confront Benny about wearing colors in the bar. We've even seen what happens after. Jodie Comer is featured as Kathy, the woman who goes to a bar to rescue her girlfriend who runs out of money. Kathy ends up hanging around the biker club when she spots Benny over a pool table. Maybe because I don't travel around the country as some other people, but I couldn't quite figure out what accent Comer as Kathy was using. I've done some reading after seeing the film, and it seems it's supposed to be a Chicago accent. To me, it seemed about as authentic as a Brooklyn accent that I see in a lot of films. Tom Hardy plays Tom Hardy. Johnny, the man who formed the Chicago Vandals, the fictional stand-in for the real-life motorcycle club that the film is based on. Johnny forms the Vandals after seeing The Wild One, a 1953 film starring Marlon Brando as the leader of a motorcycle gang that takes over a small town. That's important because it's shown in the film and is somewhat alluded to later in the film. Johnny forms the club because he just wants to ride motorcycles and hang out with fellow riders. This is Mike Faced. You may remember him from Challengers. He plays the photographer, the chronicler of the Chicago Vandals. Apparently, according to the cast list that I've seen, He's billed as Danny Lyon, although the real Danny Lyon said that this character is nothing like him. Here's today's movie word. It's logline, a noun meaning a 1 to 2 sentence synopsis of a program, script, screenplay, or book. And here's the logline for this motion picture. Set in the 1960s, The Bikeriders follows the rise of the Vandals MC, a Chicago outlaw motorcycle club. Seen through the lives of its members and their families, the club evolves over the course of a decade from a surrogate family for local outcasts into a violent, organized crime syndicate, threatening the founder's unique vision and way of life. Here's what I posted on X after I saw the film. Between the logline and the trailers, I feel misled. If you've seen the trailers for The Bikeriders, you've essentially seen The Bikeriders. Almost every critical scene, save for two, maybe three, you've seen in the trailer. I walked into the movie thinking I was going to get the chronicle of a motorcycle club becoming a crime syndicate, and what I got was a moody character study. Well filmed, well acted, but not what I expected. Which leads to a corollary. In every review, I finish by saying, watch content, form opinion. And what my intent is to say that don't believe everything you hear, don't believe everything you read. If a movie or some other content interests you, you should watch it yourself and not be influenced by what someone else says, even if that someone else is me. And certainly don't be influenced by someone if they haven't seen the content. Expectations subvert enjoyment. As regards The Bikeriders, I couldn't reconcile what I was actually seeing to what I was expecting, so I left the theater upset and disappointed. Even after processing that what I actually saw was a character study, I still couldn't reconcile what I actually saw in the film. Again, in the trailers, the aftermath of Benny being attacked in the bar was Johnny giving the order to have the bar burned down. Yet that was so completely out of character to the way Johnny was presented throughout the rest of the film. The scenes in the trailers of the bikers becoming this outlaw crime syndicate wasn't really depicted until the last half of the third act. As this was my only viewing, I wasn't satisfied in the least. Here's the 10-point scale from Track TV that I used to rank movies and television. Now, what I showed you I posted on X wasn't completely what I posted. Here's the complete tweet. Yes, I gave The Bikeriders a 4 out of 10. That's equivalent to 2 stars on a 5-star scale. Maybe after a time I can go back and rewatch The Bikeriders and have a different opinion. I have no problem with character studies, but I do have a problem with being sold one thing and receiving quite another. The Bikeriders is rated R by the Motion Picture Association for language throughout, violence, some drug use, and brief sexuality. As I always say, watch content, form opinion. Just heard mine, I'd like to hear yours. Just remember, expectations subvert enjoyment. Next week, we're going to see A Quiet Place Day One, starring Lupita Nyong'o, Joseph Quinn, and Jimin Hounsou, three people trying to escape from New York when blind invaders with an uncanny sense of hearing attack the Earth. It's a prequel to John Krasinski's prior 2 films about a family dealing with these same aliens, and it's presented in advance of a 3rd film by Krasinski about that family. A Quiet Place Day One, while a prequel, is considered a separate story from the other 2 films. We'll see how this film measures up when I review the film Friday at 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific, and 11 p.m. globally. Our roster is set for the month of July at a special time, Wednesday, July 3rd at 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific, and 9 p.m. Greenwich Mean Time. We'll review the fourth film in its franchise, Beverly Hills Cop Axel F., after its premiere on Netflix. Then it's back to the movie house on July 12th when we see Scarlett Johansson and Channing Tatum in Fly Me to the Moon, the story of a marketing executive and an astronaut preparing for the Apollo 11 moon landing. Conspiracy theorists will love this film. As I say, every time I talk about Twisters, I'm really looking forward to it. Glenn Powell, Daisy Edgar Jones, and Anthony Ramos battle those forces of nature in theater Friday, July the 19th. And finally, Marvel Studios and the Walt Disney Company are betting the MCU farm on the one motion picture about the Marvel Cinematic Universe being released in 2024. We already know the movie will make money, but how will we be talking about the picture after it premieres Thursday, July 25th? Anticipation is high, but you've already been lectured about expectations. Well, that's it for this week's edition of the Matinee. Once again, please comment down below with your opinion of the BIKERIDERS and this review. Please like and share this video and all the videos on this channel, which I hope you and your friends will subscribe to. Follow me at MikeylitoLIVE on all these social media networks, although you primarily find me on X and right here on YouTube. You can also follow me on my leisure blog at MikeylitoBlog and my opinion blog at MikeylitoCom. Until Friday, once I change my shorts after seeing A Quiet Place Day One, this is Mikeylito, as always, saying stay safe, be well, thanks for watching, and until the next time, ciao for now.